Good morning, dear children. Welcome to today's class. Let us start our day with a wonderful thought. If you are curious, you will find the puzzles around you. If you are determined, you will solve them. Let us continue with the third chapter, HCF and LCM. So children, get ready with your textbook and notebook. In the previous videos, you have learnt about how to find LCM using prime factorization method. Also, you have learnt the formula product of the two given numbers is equal to HCF multiplied by LCM. Today, we are going to learn the use of LCM and HCF. Here we will see where you can use LCM and HCF in a daily life. For that, let us see an example. A shop sells a 450 gram of bottle of jam for 96 rupees and a bigger bottle of 600 gram for 124 rupees. Which bottle is it more profitable to buy? Now here children, when you go to the market, you find various articles at different sizes and different cost. So if you have to decide which one is profitable, you have to compare them. One such method you have learnt in the previous classes is unitary method. In that, the cost of many is given, that is cost of different sizes is given. You have to find the cost of 1 gram. Here, if you find the cost of 1 gram of jam or 1 gram of jam in both the cases, you can easily compare them. But the another way this year you are going to learn is if you compare the highest common factor of both the given weights, then also you can easily compare the cost of both the bottles. That is, if you take the HCF of 450 and 600, then you can easily compare the cost. Here, you know how to find the HCF of the given numbers. So first, you will find highest common factor of 450 and 600. By calculating, you will find 150 is the HCF of 450 and 600. You will know 450 is 3 times 150, whereas 600 is 4 times 150. So, if you find the cost of 150 gram of jam, in both the cases, you can easily compare. Now, let us see how it happens. In the small bottle, 150 gram of jam cost 96 upon 3, that is 32 rupees. Now here 450 is 3 times 150. So we will divide the cost also by 3 to get the cost of 150 gram of jam. So when you divide the cost of 450 gram of bottle, that is 96 rupees by 3, you will find it comes 32 rupees. That is, if you will buy a small bottle, you have to pay 32 rupees for 150 gram. Similarly, in a large bottle, 150 gram of jam cost rupees 31. How it comes? 600 is 4 times 150. So we will divide the cost of 600 gram of bottle by 4. That is 124 by 4, you will get 31. So in large bottle, the same quantity of jam will cost 31 rupees, whereas in small bottle, the same quantity of jam cost rupees 32 rupees. From this calculation, you can easily compare that if you buy a large bottle, then it will be more profitable. Hence, it is more profitable to buy the 600 gram bottle of jam. Have you understood the example, children? Yes. Now, next. Add 17 upon 28 plus 11 upon 35. See children, in this example, you have to add two different fractions. Already you have studied these kind of examples in the previous class. But here, let us see how we can make these examples simple. For that, the method one we are looking here is the same method that you have studied in the previous class. That is, in order to add, let us make the denominators of the fractions equal. In that, here if you cross multiply, that is multiplying the denominator of the first with the numerator of the second and denominator of the second with the numerator of the first. Here if you will see, 7 is multiplied by 35. In the numerator, whatever sign is given in between both the fractions, you will put the same there. Then multiply the numerator of the second with the denominator of the first. Then multiplying both the denominators in the denominator. This is the method that you have studied in the previous classes. When you multiply 17 with 35, you will get 595. When you multiply 28 with 11, you will get 308. Now, when you multiply 28 with 35, you will get 980. In this example, you have to do the calculations of the numbers as it is given. Now, add the numerators, you will get 903 and the denominator is 980. Now, after doing the calculation, we will reduce it to the lowest form. Here, if you will see, 7 is the common factor. So, divide both the numerator and denominator by 7. You will get 129 upon 140. Now, this method you have learnt in the previous class. Let us see how can we do the calculations easier. For that, if you find the LCM of the denominator, here the denominators are 28 and 35. If you find LCM of the denominator, you will get it as 140. So, if we consider this LCM as the denominator, then we can do the calculations easily. Let us see how. Here 17 upon 28 plus 11 upon 35. LCM is 140, that is you need 140 in the denominator. For that, which number should be multiplied with the first fraction and which number should be multiplied with the second fraction can easily help you doing that. Here 140 is 28 fives are, whereas 140 is 35 fours are. So as you are multiplying the first denominator of the first fraction by 5, you will multiply with the same number in the numerator, that is 17 fives are. So you will get the first fraction as 17 fives are is 85 and 28 fives are 140. In next case, you know 35 fours are 140. So you will multiply the second fraction, numerator and denominator of the second fraction by 4. In that case, you will get 35 fours are 140 in the denominator and 11 fours are 44 in the numerator. Now here you will get 140 as the denominator. So you will add the numerators, that is 85 and 44. On adding, you will get 129 upon 140. In this case or in this type of calculation, you will get the lowest form directly. Whereas in the previous method, you will do the calculation and you have to convert the given fraction or answer of the fraction in the lowest form. Therefore, taking the LCM rather than multiplying the denominators made our calculations so much easier. So children, you should prefer taking the LCM in the denominator instead of direct multiplying or cross multiplying the denominator of the first with the numerator of the second and denominator of the second with numerator of the